In less than 2 years, my administration has accomplished more than almost any administration in the history of our country. America's so true. Didn't expect that reaction, but that's okay.
That looks set to be the headline moment of the 2018 opening of the UN General Assembly. The President of the United States walking onto the world stage Tuesday and getting laughed at. There were other memorable moments, too.
That if you cross us, our allies or our partners, if you harm our citizens, if you continue to lie, cheat, and deceive, yes, there will indeed be hell to pay.
It is ironic that the U.S. government does not even conceal its plan for overthrowing the same government it invites to talks.
The war of words Tuesday between the U.S. and Iran. And here, a rhetorical grenade lobbed Wednesday at China.
China has been attempting to interfere in our upcoming 2018 election, coming up in November, against my administration. They do not want me or us to win because I am the first president ever to challenge China on trade.
Then there was a less noticed moment, but a poignant one. Lebanese President Michel Aoun spoke Wednesday of the many Syrian migrants in his country, too many to count.
This is the best illustration of what I am trying to explain to you. Here, I would like to note that the United Nations has stopped counting the displaced in 2014. After that, the Lebanese General Security continued the count, which showed that since 2014, the number has exceeded 1.5 million displaced.
The often confrontational Turkish president put himself forward as a statesman. Venezuela's president decided to show up and then offered to meet Trump. The United Nations has a reputation for being dull and bureaucratic. Then, every September, some of the world's most controversial characters come and liven it up.
Good job, too. You do a very good job. Really good.
Owen Alterman,
yes,
I-24 News.